Hi, everyone. I'm Kevin Harlan with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. Happy to have you along for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Presented by State Farm. Here are the starters for the Minnesota Timberwolves. We've got Johnson. Williams is out there with Thompson. And it's Lewis in at the five, roaming the paint. And for the Grizzlies.
There's no other way to put it, really. I mean, the Grizzlies just devoured the East last year. I mean, they had no problems at all when they had to go out of conference. Very impressive work against the Eastern Conference for the Grizzlies.
Grizzlies and devoured. Very good special play. Very good. And the Grizzlies start out with the ball. Jones with it. He dishes it to Jones. Now here's Jones. He kicks it to Jones. Shot clock at six. Number 33. He's covered by Thompson. Gets it to go. He brought up the Grizzlies against the East. Ended up with a 15-3 record as they really showed no weakness dealing with any team, Steve, along the way.
Yeah, and another thing to note that was interesting, Kevin, they were 5-0 against the Southeast Division, which is arguably the toughest in the East. So Memphis showing just how good of a team they were last year.
So it's the Grizzlies now after the basket by Minnesota. Here's Jones on the money from 12 feet away. And about a minute gone here in the first quarter. Dishes it to Thompson. Got it. Good job in the low post. Thompson's got his first bucket in this one.
That's how you exploit that defense. Take the ball right to the basket.
All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
Hey, Kevin, I had a chance to talk with head coach of the Grizzlies. He stressed how important being smart with the ball is going to be for them today. It's an opponent that thrives on defense, steals in particular, and he doesn't want to see his guys get careless with the basketball. Guys?
Thanks for the report, Doris. Guys, what do you do to spread this defense out?
Well, I think you've got to come at them with a variety of offensive looks. Try to keep them guessing, keep their rotations a little bit off rhythm.
As usual, Steve, you're all over it. You've got to keep switching things up on them so they can't get settled into a defensive rhythm or groove. So give them something they don't expect.
Terrific play right there. Great strength to finish through the hit.
That's how you do it, the bump and the bucket.
You know, guys, the Timberwolves improved by leaps and bounds last year, and one way that really showed up was in their improvement against the Western Conference teams. Their record against Western teams much improved over the previous season.
Yes, Steve, 19-29 for the Wolves against the West for them last season. Clark, not where they want to be, but it was miles ahead of their mark the season before.
Yeah, and the season before, they only mustered up 7 wins in 52 games against the West, so anything north of double-digit wins is a big jump. I mean, they'll continue to add to that win total this year.
And defensively, you've got to try to keep the ball on the perimeter.
Yeah, he's not going to miss those, not often anyway. The defense has to muscle up and deny him that position to have a chance.
And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes played, the Timberwolves again can't hit. Number 33, he's guarded by Johnson. That's good.
Boy, they're scoring efficiently. They look very focused at the offensive end.
A nice start, no question, making all the right moves here early.
Now, here's Thompson. They need this. That's good.
Oh, he got the D that time. Nice up and under.
And he'll be shooting his first free throw of the game here. That free throw good from Thompson.
Well, you knew the Grizzlies were anticipating going deep into the playoffs after they had a nice run to the second round in 2011. They don't don't seem ready to settle for first-round exits, and they've got the personnel and coaching to be right in the thick of things going forward.
Clark, how about the previous year when they were number 8 seed, knocked off the number 1 seed San Antonio in 2010?
That's right. The defense just couldn't recover in time.
Yeah, but he pretty much went brain neutral on that one, Clark. Wouldn't you?
Yes, sir. I like that phrase.
Yeah, I don't use that phrase very often, but to me, that's what happened. He shifted the brain into neutral.
Yes, he did.
That was embarrassing.
Number 40. The jump shot from the baseline is right on target. And for the Grizzlies, they had a doozy of a matchup with the Clippers. Steve, you did a couple of those games in the first round. Exciting to watch.
Oh, man, was it ever. I mean, that series went 7 games. Remember, there was the incredible Clipper comeback in the, I think it was game 1 in Memphis. And then for the Clippers to go back to Memphis and win the deciding game on the road, that was really surprising.
Just 2 to shoot. Number 33. They get it again. And it's good. Terrific work on the offensive glass to make that one work.
Something has to change, guys. That's 10 straight points coming in the paint against this team.
Well, they got to collapse in there, and everybody's got to be conscious of it. It's a team effort in protecting the paint. Control the ball, and then everybody's got to get in there and keep the defense locked down.
Here's Thompson following the score by Memphis. Back to Williams. Jacks up a 3. That is good. Williams has got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game.
So timeout called here. The first for Memphis.
And the Grizzlies leading by 3. Here's Jones. Still looking to get on the scoreboard. Goes up at the stripe. Jones, no luck.
Really high quality shot there. Just a little off with his release.
That miss right there will definitely leave him shaking his head.
And here is Williams. Number 40, and that one's good.
Well, the main strength of his is his finishing ability in tight. And even if you get a body on him, he can power it through the contact.
And Steve, he's a player that's extremely hard to cool off. I mean, he picks up right where he left off after every break in the action, it seems. Timeouts, halftime, it doesn't matter. When he's hot, he stays hot.
Number 33, and what was that about? Not a good shot right there. Right side, Williams. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot 2.
Very close to a 3-point play right there.
Yeah, that didn't go down, but those are exactly the plays coaches like to see.
The Timberwolves have gone 1-for-1, making their previous attempt at the line.
And you know, a lot of times, guys, in some of their performances last year, their free throw numbers help them win games.
And that one falls for Williams. So both teams changing it up here. Good on the second, so he makes them both. Grizzlies have gone 8-12 on field goal attempts so far. Now Warren. Rebound by Williams. Timberwolves have gone 6-9, shooting it well. Shots good by Williams.
Right out of the gate, just filling it up.
Both teams are, guys. I mean, points coming fast and furious.
There's the pass to Warren. 5 to shoot. Here's Jones. Solid play in the low block, and that one's good. Timberwolves have gotten 7 of their first 10 attempts to fall so far. Excellent pace to their offense. Number 21, up and in on the layup. And the Timberwolves lead by 1.
Now they've got to offer more resistance inside. Just too many easy buckets in the paint.
Yeah, Steven, that's the top priority for any defense. You got to protect the paint.
Swift inside. He's against Williams. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
Second team.
The Grizzlies shooting their second and third free throws tonight.
You know, Kevin, they would love to post a similar percentage again this season. I mean, I think that's safe to say they'd love to shoot free throws as well as they did a year ago.
The first one falls. Both teams deciding to change it up. He's perfect from the line this time.
Boy, he's knocking them down. No surprise there. He's one of the premier free throw shooters in the league.
.151 left here in the first quarter. Gets the bucket. Williams has got his second bucket.
This is an interesting matchup. Neither team has been able to get an edge.
I tell you what, it's been enjoyable to watch this one. I mean, they haven't given an inch to each other, and neither side is backing down in this one.
And it's the Grizzlies with the ball. They trail by one. Six on the shot clock. They set the pick. Shot from the wing. The shot misses. So Minnesota will take it the other way. 1:11 left in the first quarter of the game. Shot from the top of the key. Can't hit.
Well, he's wide open there, but really struggles from that range. Maybe there's a reason he's open.
Here's Swift. A strong finish under heavy pressure all over. And the Grizzlies lead by one.
They are in attack mode right now. That's 10 straight points, guys, all coming inside the paint.
And Steve, if I'm him, I'd keep going right to the heart of that defense like they have been until they do something about it. If they don't offer resistance, take everything you can get in there.
Now here's Williams. Left side Williams on the money from 12 feet away. Williams has got six. Clark and Steve, this tug-of-war game continues.
You know what? And they just keep flip-flopping the lead again and again and again.
Yeah, how about that last lead change, guys? That's number seven for the game.
Number 33. Rebound, Minnesota. Outside, Williams. And the shot is good. And now it's a three-point Timberwolves lead.
Well, for him, that Timberwolves is almost second nature. That's a tough shot for most players.
All right, his first quarter of play. We've seen plenty of offense so far. Timberwolves lead by three. And we'll be back with you for the start of the second quarter when we return. And the second quarter getting underway. No team gaining an edge so far. And guys, what's your take so far in the Timberwolves?
Big boost from their bench there, guys, in that first quarter. They did a nice job coming in and really giving this team a lift.
Yeah, it's a nice attribute to have. Firepower coming off the pine early. That's good stuff.
And a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. So the Grizzlies five right now. Lewis gets the bucket.
That's five straight hoops in the paint. What a fantastic job of attacking the rim.
Well, Steve, they're getting the looks that they want down there, so might as well keep going right at the rim. If there's no resistance, then make them pay.
Timberwolves leading by five. Number 40, and again it's Minnesota. The Grizzlies shooting has just been outstanding tonight. 56% as a team in this game. Warren kicks to Jones. And we play through the first minute here in the second. Six to shoot. With the drop step. Kept alive.
First team.
So both teams making some changes here. They set the pick to the middle. Goes up off the pick. Goes up high for the two-handed dunk.
Well, that's a solidly executed pick play. I mean, it paid dividends with that nice dunk.
Exactly the result they were looking for.
Yeah, it worked so well. I mean, he got set, did not shuffle his feet. Really well done there offensively.
Minnesota with the ball, following the score by Memphis. Second quarter of basketball, just over a minute and a half played so far. Here's Kennedy. Shot no good. And the Grizzlies going the other way now. Here's Jones. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Yeah, he's a terror in the passing lanes too. Loves to lay back a bit, kind of play possum, anticipate, and then dash out and pick off those careless passes.
And you know, he's got another skill that you love to see in a player. The ability to create a high-quality shot for himself off the dribble.
And the first one drops. Both teams will make substitutions. He makes one of two that time. Timberwolves leading by four. Williams in the post, defended by Jones. Shot's good by Williams.
Carving them up inside there, Kevin. I mean, the defense has been vulnerable in there.
Yeah, that's three straight field goals in the paint area. That's really good offense.
Now here's Jones. Over Williams. And the basket by Jones. Jones has got five now. The Timberwolves have gone 3 of 4 from the floor here in the second quarter. Here's Williams. Lays it in off the expert drop step.
Just too easy. They're getting whatever they want down there.
You said it, Steve. Five straight field goals inside for him. The defense has to clamp down here.
Now here's Jones. 5 points in the game. The feed to Jones. Lock at six. Number 33. And another basket for Memphis. And for those of you just joining us, we're in the second quarter with about 3 minutes gone by. Kicks it to Johnson. Cannot hit. And Memphis the other way now. He feeds it to Jones. The dish to Jones. And the shot is good. Now just a 2-point Timberwolves lead.
Nice touch near the hoop.
So the Timberwolves call their first timeout.
You know, he wants to tinker a little bit, and he's taking the time to do so right here.
Yeah, I think you're right. He just didn't like some of the things he saw out there, a bit uncomfortable, and wanted to talk it over.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played, outside Williams. He passes it to Williams. And the whistle blows, and it's going to be an over-the-back call here.
Well, I love the fact that he's fighting hard on the boards, but, you know, you got to be smart, too. Over-the-back, that's an easy call there.
Well, that's simply the result of poor position under the glass. But at least you can't fault him for being passive. He was trying to be aggressive there.
Williams against Jones. Over Williams, and it's Memphis with another.
Well, they keep going right back to the paint, and who can blame them? I mean, they're getting it done in there.
Yeah, three of their last five buckets, guys, have come from inside the lane area, so I'd expect them to continue to go inside right at the defense.
Here's Williams. Grizzlies making the shot. Shot clock at six. From deep, the Grizzlies pull it in.
He hit a three in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
Here's Jones, and the Grizzlies tack on two more.
They didn't get off to much of a start early on, but seems to have shaken off the rust here in the quarter.
Outside Williams. Johnson kicks to Williams. Looking to end the drought. Gets it to go. Williams has got 12 points in the game. The Grizzlies have gone 6 of 8 from the field in the second quarter. Jones with it. He's got 7. Just 5 on the clock. Baseline jumper. Blocked. And they get it back. And it's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over. Both teams will make substitutions. Timberwolves have gotten just over 50% of their shots to drop here in the second quarter. They're 5 for 9. Kelly, defended by Jones. The Timberwolves working the ball around now. 6 on the shot clock. Number 40. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot. The Timberwolves shooting their 4th and 5th attempts at the free throw line tonight.
And, you know, that just added to their confidence at the offensive end. I mean, knowing that free throw shooting was something they didn't have to worry about gave them a lot of confidence to play freely.
And he makes the first. And the Grizzlies making a change here. Good on both. Memphis trailing here. Back to Davis. Passes it to Warren. Over Thompson. And the shot by Warren, no good. The Timberwolves shooting has been brilliant in this game, 67% from the floor. Good look, and that one's good. He's got 10.
They can't fault what he's been doing out there. Some really impressive shooting.
They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. Now here's Jones. He's got 5. Warren. Money from the wing.
Well, no doubt. I mean, we're going to see him take some three-pointers. That's what he does. He's a great shooter from long range. So defensively, you've got to keep an eye on him and close out hard on him. Make him put the ball on the floor.
And I don't think we can talk about him without also mentioning his tendency to just erupt and string together a bunch of baskets in a row in a real short period of time.
Seems to be getting better as this game goes on.
Feeds to Jones. He dishes it to Warren. Releases the good-looking shot from the wing. 1:27 left now here in the second. Pass to Thompson. He goes up, smooth as silk on the finger roll. Thompson's got 7.
You know, if their plan was to keep going inside a ton, it sure has paid off. I mean, it seems like every bucket they get is in the lane.
Well, no reason to take an outside shot if you're scoring at will from inside the paint.
Now here's Jones. And there's the 3-second call, this one on the defense. The Grizzlies have shot 80% from the line tonight, going 4-5 so far.
Yeah, they had the kind of success from the line that would make any coach breathe a sigh of relief, guys.
And so he hits the technical free throw.
It really didn't seem to matter to the Timberwolves last year whether they were playing home or away. They had the same record in both categories.
58 seconds left to play in the first half. There's a screen to the paint. Swift. And that one's good. 7 points in the game.
That's going to be important for this team to fight over the top of screens defensively.
Yeah, you got to tag him and stay right close to him because with his touch, he doesn't need much space to get his shot off.
And that record you mentioned, Clark, 13-20. Not a terrible mark on the road for the Wolves, given all the injury woes they had. And see if they're going to look to improve that, I'm sure.
Yeah, and that number got worse at the end of the year after they suffered some injuries. So I don't think their road record was as bad as what it ended up to look like. No question, they've got some talent. This is a big season for them, though, and they've got to establish themselves on the road if they're going to be a playoff contender.
He gathers. That's good. Number 40. Count it from 12. He's got 14.
That's a nice job of getting the ball in the paint and burying the shot. That's exactly how it's done.
Second quarter ends in a tight one. But Timberwolves on top, leading by three. And get ready now for the Sprint Halftime Show with Damon Bruce. The second half will be coming up right after that on 2K Sports.
Now, presented by Sprint.
Fridays are made for basketball, and now, from the 2K Sports Studios, we're happy to bring you the Halftime Show. The Minnesota Timberwolves have the lead against Memphis, having their way on offense, and that may be an understatement. They simply can't miss. And there's no quitting the Grizzlies. They came to win. They've done a great job closing out their defensive possessions, grabbing boards, great rebounding. That'll wrap things up for me here in the studio. Thanks so much. I'm Damon Bruce. Now let's get back out to Kevin Harlan for the second half of play.
And it's been a back-and-forth game so far with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter starting here now. Timberwolves leading by three on the court for Minnesota. We've got Williams. He's out there with Thompson. And it's Lewis in at the center position. And Jones pulls it down.
Couldn't convert, but nice little two-man game there.
And it wouldn't surprise me to see them go back to that the next trip.
Exceptional play to take the bump and still get it up and down.
Yeah, way to stay with it and look to finish the play right there.
Well, for a long time, the Grizzlies had been looking for something to build on, but with the core group of players that they have now, I think they have a really bright future. This is a team that defends, they play well together, and they've got really good interior passing as well.
Well, you mentioned the interior passing, Steve. The Grizzlies worked so well as a unit. Clark, they just picked you apart.
Yeah, and they didn't really have huge assist numbers as a team, but Gasol was one of the best passing centers, and Spates and Randolph combined for quite a few helpers as well.
Williams gets the bucket.
The defense playing way too soft there, guys. He's just getting right to the rim.
The Grizzlies shooting 64%. Beautiful all-around play by this offense. Jones against Williams. There's the bucket. Good. He's got 13.
Boy, a nice little trend developing here, fellas. I mean, that's 8 of their last 10 from inside the paint.
Yeah, they're getting high percentage looks down there. Their offense is really clicking. I don't see why they wouldn't just continue to pound the ball inside.
He kicks to Thompson. Gets it to go. Thompson's got 9.
He is always so in control, guys, even when he's going hard to the hoop. Very skilled finisher.
Jones kicks to Jones. And it's good.
Hot start for this club coming out of halftime. That's three in a row now.
The Timberwolves have gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. Dishes to Johnson. Fades back. And there are the Timberwolves with another bucket.
That's 3 for 4 field goal shooting here in the third. So offensively, they're looking good.
2 minutes into the second half of play now. Now here's Jones. He's got 7. 6 to shoot. From inside, count the bucket. Jones has got 9.
That's 4 straight field goals coming inside the paint.
Boy, they're taking it right to him, Steve, and the defense has really been way too passive for my liking.
And the Timberwolves call time. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. Outside Williams. Lock at 6. Let's it go from 14.
Solid advantage in the rebounding totals for them so far here.
You know, in every game, but particularly in a close game, every little advantage you can use helps, and they're certainly enjoying one on the glass here.
He's a bit short for the power forward spot, but his great leaping ability more than makes up for it.
Clock keeps going. 3 minutes into the second half now. Inside. Shot clock at 6. The shot clock violation. Great team.
You cannot afford to make mistakes like that here in a tight game.
The Timberwolves making a switch here. Third quarter action and just under 3.5 minutes have gone. Clark, this offense has really been clicking.
No doubt about it, giving the defense all kinds of trouble.
And they're playing with so much energy offensively, the ball is really moving.
Timeout called, the Grizzlies. Here's Jones. He's got 9. And the pass to Jones. Jones with the screen on Thompson. And the basket by Jones. And it's a 4-point Grizzly lead.
Boy, this is the kind of shooting performance coaches dream of. It makes their job so much easier. An excellent start to this third quarter.
Drops it in from 11 feet. 16 points for him.
That shooting percentage is off the charts, guys. He's really hitting his shots today.
Jones has got 12 in the game.
And the pace has really ramped up in the second half.
Steve, I like the re-energized effort here. I mean, it's been a battle.
Yeah, the referee's all over that one.
No doubt about it. Clearly a foul. Nothing to argue about there.
The Timberwolves have yet missed a free throw. 5 for 5.
Yeah, very average shooting team in terms of the free throw line. About 76% a year ago.
You know, something you can point to when you're talking about their areas of success last season, free throw shooting.
He misses the free throw, so both teams making some changes here.
And the second free throw, good. And the Grizzlies leading by three. And here's Jones. He's got nine. There's the feed to Jones. Shot clock at five. Shot is off. And Minnesota will come the other way. Offside, Williams. Puts up the runner and hits. Williams has got 14 points for the game. Grizzlies have gotten nearly everything to drop this quarter. They're 7 of 8 from the floor since halftime. Now Jones. Kicks to Jones. Gets a look. The shot is off.
Boy, for my taste, he's far too inconsistent with that shot. I mean, he's got to make those if he's going to take his game to the next level.
That puts them in the lead. 18 points for him. And Clark and Steve, as we approach the fourth quarter, still anyone's ball game.
Yeah, exactly right, Kevin. I mean, these teams just simply keep trading baskets and, as a result, trading the lead.
Yeah, neither side really able to create much of a cushion at all. So, you know, which team can make a little run here? We'll see.
That's good. So it's the Timberwolves now. It's a one-point game. The Timberwolves working the ball around now. Goes right up. Hammers it home.
All business there. Not messing around one bit. Flushed it right with one hand.
He never does, Clark. He never does.
Well, that's kind of his trademark. Those slams like that one.
The Timberwolves have shot 6 of 7 at the line.
And you can't take those numbers lightly, fellas. I mean, their free throw shooting made a difference for them in a lot of their games last season.
So Memphis ends up going with the new group. The Grizzlies have gone 8 of 10 shooting here in the second half. Very strong. Warren with the ball. Here's Swift. And the three off target. Minnesota in the lead. Shot's good by Williams. Williams has got 4 points now in the quarter. The Grizzlies shooting 65%, an outstanding offensive display from them. Jones kicks to Warren. That drops. And so it's Minnesota with it. Outside Williams. Pulls up on the elbow. And there's another one for the Timberwolves.
Boy, he's really having a nice quarter. Made some big shots for him.
Here's Warren. 6 points for him. He feeds it to Jones. With the lead pass. That's good. He's got eight.
Right now, they're just pillow-like inside. Way too soft. Too many looks at and around the hoop.
Yep, totally agree, Clark. 10 of the last 12 points now that they've surrendered have come inside that lane area.
Number 40 misses the jumper.
You're not doing your team any good forcing a shot like that one.
You know, I agree. He's got to know better than that.
Number 25. And it's going to be a goaltending call here, so they'll count the bucket.
He thought he had that one clean, but the ref saw it differently. They'll count the basket.
So both teams changing it up here. And for the Timberwolves, they're shooting an unreal 70% from the field, making a mockery of this defense. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to Doris Burke for an update. Hi, Doris.
Gentlemen, the Timberwolves seem to be turning a corner in respectability, and even the real powerhouse teams in the league are taking notice. Reigning MVP and NBA champion LeBron James said, they're a good team. If they continue on the path that they're on now, they can become a playoff team because they have veterans and they have young guys. When you have that type of mix and that chemistry with Coach Adelman and their system, they can do it. If not right now, then very soon. Gentlemen, we'll see.
Doris, a lot of promise on this team. We'll see how they develop. There's 47 seconds left here in the third quarter.
Now here's Jones. He's got 11. The dish now to Jones. Six on the shot clock. Fades away. Lewis grabs the board.
That's as high percentage as it gets for him. I mean, the defense really has to be mindful of not giving him that kind of space to operate.
1 second separating the shot clock and game clock. Here's Thompson. Off the mark and a bad shot there. Here's Jones. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up. It's his first trip to the line. And that one falls for Jones. Both teams deciding to change it up. And so Jones nails both of them. Number 40. No good on the buzzer beater. And as we conclude the third quarter, what a game. Neither team giving ground. Grizzlies lead by two. And we'll have the start of a fourth quarter for you as soon as we get back from this short break. Memphis leading. They've got Jones. Jones is out there with Davis. Then it's Jones. That's the lineup in the game for Memphis. 11 feet away. And the basket by Jones. Jones has got the fourth quarter going with the first basket of the period here for the Grizzlies. Left side, Williams. Back to Williams. Five on the clock. Easy shot. The shot is off. Now the Grizzlies take it the other way. And here's Jones. The stupendous finish in traffic. And it's a 6-point Grizzly lead.
That's four of their last five buckets now coming in the paint area.
And they're in attack mode right now, barreling in there with bad man intention.
Now here's Williams. Here's Johnson. The Grizzlies pull it in. Jones has got his fourth rebound in this one.
Really strong performance by them so far on the glass.
You know, the lead they have in the rebounding category is also part of the reason they're on top on the scoreboard as well.
Here's Jones. Jones kicks to Jones. Over Williams. And it's Memphis with another.
They continue to build on this lead.
Yeah, they're trying to get a little more separation, Steve, and they actually have a chance to do it the way they're making plays at both ends.
Just about 1.5 minutes gone by here in the fourth. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
They got to find something, you're right.
Back to Lewis. And the shot is good.
Boy, they are really getting chewed up inside here. I mean, that's 8 of the last 10 points they've given up inside, in the paint.
Yeah, and the paint should be sacred ground for a defense. I mean, you can't let anybody just trot in there and get an easy bucket.
Timeout called, the Grizzlies. And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Hey, guys, over that last break, I was able to catch the message the Grizzlies head coach was giving to his team. He told the players, let's put our foot on them and keep them down. We've got them exactly where we want them. I want to see you guys slow the pace, use the clock, and stay away from any silly fouls.
Passes it to Jones. Jones sets the pick for Jones. Down low. And the basket by Jones. And the Grizzlies lead by 8.
And the shootout continues.
Trading buckets both ways. I mean, offense definitely the focal point for these teams.
And Lewis backs down. Goes up. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here. The free throw drops for Lewis. Jones checked in for Memphis. And both free throws good for Lewis. Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation. Feeds it to Jones. To the inside. Over Thompson. And the Grizzlies tack on 2 more. Timberwolves trailed by 8. Gets the bucket. The Grizzlies have gotten every shot they've taken so far in the fourth quarter to go in. That's 5 in a row to start the quarter. Memphis moving that ball around. Number 33. And the defense really pressing up on him. Made that a tough shot. He dishes it to Williams. Who is outside. He passes to Thompson. Grizzlies with the rebound. Over 3.5 minutes through the final quarter now. Gets it to go.
Well, we've seen this from him before. Once he gets going, look out.
Timberwolves trailed by 8. Right side, Williams. Pass to Thompson. Tries it from 19. The shot misses. Grizzlies have gotten it done so far from the field here in the fourth, going 6 for 7. He kicks it to Jones. That's good. And it's a 10-point Grizzly lead.
I like the way they got the ball inside there.
Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
Minnesota calls timeout.
You know, all coaches hate defensively when you give up easy points in the paint. That's inexcusable. So that's the reason for this timeout here.
I think it came down to the fact they were getting beat inside, and that's why the coach called timeout. They were not winning the battle inside.
Williams, he's checked in for Minnesota. And Minnesota has possession, trailing by 10. Gets it to go.
Boy, just battled through that initial impact and somehow willed it in.
Excellent concentration. That's what you like to see.
And that one falls for Johnson. And the Grizzlies leading by 7. Jones dishes to Jones. Back to Jones. Shot clock at 6. Here's Jones. That's good. Jones has got 8 here in the quarter.
You know, he's yet to miss in the quarter. Flawless efficiency from the field. I like it.
and that one falls for Jones.
That's amazing. They have yet to miss a free throw this half.
And as calm and collected as they look up there, I'm not sure they'll ever miss one the rest of the way.
Now here's Williams. Thompson up top. Dishes it to Lewis. Thompson up top. Over Jones. Thompson with the bucket.
Now they may have to climb on his back to get back into this game.
Now Jones. The pass to Jones. Number 33. And the Grizzlies tack on two more. Timberwolves trail by 10. Outside Williams. The feed to Thompson. And that one's good. Thompson's got 9 points here in the second half. And the Grizzlies leading by 8. Jones with it. Kicks it to Jones. He feeds it to Jones. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
Well, probably the right play defensively. If you can't get the block, send them to the free throw line. Don't give them an easy 2.
No easy buckets inside. Force free throws and work to keep them out of the lane next time around.
Williams, he's checked in for Williams. That one is no good.
Well, the old adage was whoever gets the best player wins the trade. But the Nuggets traded away Carmelo and the Jazz traded away Darren Williams, and both made the playoffs last season and have a foundation laid now for great success going forward.
The Grizzlies shooting 71% all in all in this one. They've been brilliant offensively. Back to Jones. The dish to Jones. The shot from the low post is good. Jones has got 7 points here in this quarter. And you look at these Nuggets and Jazz teams, Steve, and you have to think they're pretty happy with the value they got in return for those trades Clark just talked about.
Yeah, especially in situations where you know you're going to lose your player. Everybody in the league knows you're going to lose your star player. So you really don't have great leverage. And I thought both the Nuggets and the Jazz did an excellent job of maxing out those trades and doing about as well as they possibly could.
And Minnesota has possession. It's a 10-point game. Open look. And there's another one for the Timberwolves. And so here's Memphis. Pass to Jones. Count that one. Jones has got 20. Minnesota calls timeout. They're trailing by 10. 1:52 left to play in the final quarter. Outside Williams. There's the screen. Feeds to Thompson. That one goes. Come. Thompson's got 11 in the second half. Here's Jones. He'd better get going. Now here's Jones. Inside, lock at 6, gets it to go. Jones has got 10 points now just in this quarter.
I think he set in the tone for the entire team in this quarter. Tremendous stuff, good action.
1:10 left in the fourth quarter.
And the shot is good from Johnson.
Came off the screen and did what I call a right now move, right to the rim. The defense had no time to recover.
Number 33 gets it to go. He's got 19.
Now there's something for the top 10 highlight reel right there. A layup can be just as sweet and as pretty as a dunk sometimes.
Now here's Williams. Number 40. And again, it's Minnesota converting. And here's Jones. He dishes it to Jones. Back to Jones. Let's it fly from 18. Timberwolves on offense, trailing here by 8. Lewis, defended by Jones. 7 second difference, shot and game clock. Down low. Lewis gets the bucket. Grizzlies shooting 71% all in all in this one. They've been brilliant offensively. There's 18 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. And now we've got the intentional foul. He doesn't hit the first. That's good. Going 1 of 2 from the line, and that makes it a 7-point lead. Minnesota calls timeout. They're behind by 7. 17 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. What's your take, guys?
Well, talk all they want, but I just don't see a way for them to get back into the game here.
You know what? I don't know if there's a 10-point play out there, and that being the case, this one is finished. Over.
Williams inside, Swift on him. It falls! Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5. 12 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And that's an intentional foul. He hits the first one, and that increases their lead to 6. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a 7-point game.
And now the lead really is looking very secure after those 2 free throws. Nice job.
Open look. It's in! Five seconds left in the fourth quarter. And they go to the intentional foul. And that increases their lead to 6. And the Grizzlies making a change here. And he's unable to get the second one. Number 40. No good. So it's Memphis picking up the win. Both teams played well, but these guys had the edge.
Yeah, I think so. They were just steak knife sharp. Very on top of their game here.
Well said. Well, that'll do it for us. For Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, Kevin Harlan saying so long. As we end the game, we bring you our Jordan Player of the Game.
I go on and on. Can't understand how I last so long. I must have superpowers. Rap 225,000 hours. Get a calculator, do the math. I made 1,000 songs that made you move your